So ninth class, we are again back and let us discuss the concepts of OpenOffice Writer. Yesterday, I finished the topic at Format Paintbrush. I quickly revised the role of Format Paintbrush. Format Paintbrush is a tool that is used to copy the formatting from one place to another place. If you want to copy the formatting done in one area to other area, you can do it with the help of Format Paintbrush tool. Like suppose I am typing one sentence here using Arial font, or let us say Verdana font, size is 18, bold and in red color. I type the sentence. Let me take the color here. This color. Computer period is going on, right? So I type this sentence in red color, right? Now I have one more line here. Let us say I type in Arial font. And its color is black. I type the fourth period is computer. I type this text in black color. Okay. Now, if you want to copy the formatting done in this data over this data, like for example, I select this data, click on the Format Paintbrush tool. Okay. This icon will be changed to bucket shape. Click and select it. See, the formatting done on the previous line is incorporated to the next line. Have you noticed? Have you all noticed the formatting which was done on the data computer period is going on? It is copied on to the next line. The fourth period is computer. If you want to check, I just tell you. I type this line in Verdana font, 18 size with bold. Now select this line. See, the same font is coming, Verdana. The same size is coming. But before this formatting, this line was in Arial font. This line was in Arial font. But after copying the formatting, the line having face, having style, Verdana. Am I clear with Format Paintbrush working? Yes, ninth class. Lavanya, Jia, is the concept clear? All right. Now, let us proceed with further formatting, paragraph formatting. Suppose you are typing any paragraph, like due to COVID-19 pandemic, we are having online classes daily from 8:30 a.m. to 12:15 p.m. as and when situation will get better, school will start offline classes, so all of us let's think positive and pray to God for better situation. Right? Or pray to God for a good health. Now, this is a paragraph which I have typed. Now, if you want to do formatting to a paragraph, for that, you select the paragraph, click on Format menu. You have to choose the paragraph option. When you click on the paragraph option, paragraph dialog box appears. Now, in the paragraph dialog box, I speak out the name of tabs. As I told you yesterday that you must be aware about the tabs which are present in the particular dialog box, like character dialog box, font, font effects, hyperlink, position, background. Similarly, in paragraph dialog box, we have indent and spacing tab, alignment tab, text flow tab, outline and numbering tab, tabs, drop caps, borders, background. Okay? Am I clear? So there are total 8 tabs present in paragraph dialog box: indent and spacing, alignment, text flow, outline and numbering, tabs, drop caps, borders, and background. So you can click on the desired tab and you can make the settings for the paragraph, whichever settings you want. Like you can give indentation. You can specify indentation. Okay. You can increase or decrease the value as per your requirement. Clear? Then you can give paragraph spacing. Okay. Then you can set the line spacing. Right? Am I clear? You can set the alignment by clicking on alignment tab. Right? Am I clear? Then text flow, then outline and numbering. If you want to give bullet and numbering feature, drop caps. Now in drop cap, the first letter or first word will be in the large position moving towards down. See the figure here. The first letter of the first word of the paragraph is in large size and dropping down. Then you can apply borders if you want. Like you can have border around. Okay. You can specify the thickness of the border. You can specify the color of the border. Clear? Then the background, you can set any background if you want for your paragraph. See, all the settings I have done for the paragraph. This is first line indent. This is first line indent. This is the line spacing. This is the border around the paragraph. And the background color has been set. Alignment is justified. So many formattings I have done on the paragraph. Have you noticed all the changes? Yes, 9th. So once again, I repeat how to make settings for the paragraph. Select the paragraph, click on Format menu, choose the paragraph option. Okay, am I clear? And paragraph dialog box will appear and you can click on the desired tab to make the desired settings as per your convenience. Clear? Any doubt? Navedita, concept is clear? Jayant Chhabra, Dipali? Kanish, Gurshan, Dhwani? Very few thumbs are raised. Why so? All right. Now I open the new page. And I type one more paragraph over here. Okay. We should respect our elders, teachers, grandparents, comma, parents. We should get up early in the morning. We should take bath daily. We should attend our online classes sincerely and with full honesty and dedication. Right? Am I clear? Now, anybody raise your hand and tell me how many times I have pressed the enter key. How many times I press the enter key? Come on the video and give the answer. Whosoever wants to give the answer, on your video first. Whosoever wants to give the answer, video must be on. Yes, Chaitanya, unmute yourself. Your voice is not audible, Chaitanya, unmute yourself. Unmute yourself. Okay, Japji, you tell me, unmute yourself, Japji.
Sir, you haven't clicked enter key.
11 enter keys?
Sir, you haven't. Sir, aapne key nahi hai click.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Sir, aapne enter key click ki nahi ki, kyunki iska ek, kyunki sir, word wrap ki wajah se.
I click here the enter key. I click here.
Sir, but because of the feature of WordWrap.
You are right. You are right. WordWrap feature is always there. See here, I type one more sentence. I press the enter key. That is why cursor is coming down. See here, Japji. We should be ready for exams as and when date sheet will come to us. Here I didn't press the enter key. Here your WordWrap feature is coming because as I proceed towards the right margin, the text automatically flows to the next line due to WordWrapping feature. But here after dedication, I press the enter key. Got it, Japji? You are right at your side. In this sentence, I didn't press the enter key. Here I press the enter key. Because you see, the line has not reached to the end of right margin. The line finishes before the right margin. Got it, bete? Ab yahan dekho, beta. We should take bath daily. डेली तो मार्जिन से पहले ही खत्म हो गया, मैं राइट मार्जिन की ओर तो गया ही नहीं। नाउ ओके जब जी, वन मोर क्वेश्चन, हैव आई गिवन स्पेस, हैव आई गिवन स्पेस? Yes, of course, I have given the space. How many spaces after each word?
Sir, one space.
Yes, one space, normal space. Very right, one space. Okay. Now see, is there any representation of space? क्या space को हम किसी symbol से represent कर सकते हैं? क्या एंटर की को हम किसी सिंबल से रिप्रेजेंट कर सकते हैं? इज देयर एनी की ऑन द कीबोर्ड विच आई प्रेस एंड एंटर की इज विजिबल, कि यहां पर मेरी एंटर की प्रेस हुई है? नाउ आई प्रेस वन शॉर्टकट की, सी हेयर, carefully see all of you, can you see the dot and this paragraph mark, this symbol, the reverse P? How many of you are able to view this dots in between and this reverse P, the paragraph mark symbol? First of all of you come on the video. For this lecture, I request everyone to be on the video so that I can interact with you people. All those who are sincerely attending the lecture, come on the video. All right. Gurshan, Prabhjot, have you noticed the symbols which have been placed? Dot in between and at the end, where sentence is finished, this paragraph mark symbol, reverse P, is displayed. The dot signifies that here the user has pressed the space bar. This paragraph mark symbol represents that user has pressed the enter key. See, here I didn't press the enter key. So here that symbol is not coming, because here word wrap feature was there. How this symbols came? These symbols are called non-printing characters. What they are called? Non-printing characters. If you want to show non-printing characters, how you can show? By pressing the shortcut key. See, the number of time I will press the enter key, it will come. Shortcut key to print the non-printing character is Control plus F10. As I will give space, dot is coming. See, I am pressing the space bar key. The number of times I am pressing the space bar key, dot is coming. Have you noticed? So in order to display non-printing characters are those which are never shown in the printing. Aap jab iska printout nikaloge, aap jab normal document ka printout nikalte ho, can you see the space and the enter key pressed? क्या एंटर की वहां विजिबल होती है? नो. इज देयर एनी पर्टिकुलर सिंबल फॉर स्पेस? नो. नाउ अगेन आई प्रेस कंट्रोल प्लस F10. सी द सिंबल्स आर गॉन, अगेन वी आर बैक टू द नॉर्मल डॉक्यूमेंट. Clear? The role of non-printing characters. So what is the shortcut key to display the non-printing characters? Control plus F10. You can note it down. Control plus F10. Okay. Am I clear to all of you, 9th class? Any doubt? All right. Now let us proceed to the next important topic of writer. How to set page formatting. Character formatting we have done. Paragraph formatting we have done. How to set the page formatting. In order to set the page formatting, click on the format menu. Choose the page option. Page style dialog box will appear. There are several tabs here. Organizer, page, background, header, footer, borders, columns, footnote. Okay. So these are the tabs which are available in the page dialog box. Click on the organizer, then page. In the page tab, when you will click, you can see the various settings. Like you can make your page portrait orientation or landscape orientation. Default orientation is portrait. Your page will be printed lengthwise. When you go with the landscape, it will be printed breadthwise. Okay? Clear? Then you can set the margins here also. See, you can set the margins. How much margins you want to set, specify here. You can make the settings as per your convenience. Okay? See, this is the landscape form. Clear to all of you? Background if you want. Then borders if you want around the page. Okay. You can set the borders. Right? See? I just convert it into portrait form. See this. Now here you can type your data. I am studying in SSDPS. Okay. I am in 9C class. My name is Raghav. Okay. So you can make settings for the pages or page also. So three type of formatting you have done: character formatting, paragraph formatting, and page formatting. Now there is one short assignment for you people. Tomorrow I will take oral test and I'll be asking you about the name of the tabs which are present in all the three dialog boxes. You should be aware about the tab name in the particular dialog box. Ki character dialog box mein kaun se tab hai, paragraph dialog box mein kaun se tab hai, along with the shortcut keys. I'll be discussing shortcut keys also with you. So there will be 5 minutes oral test tomorrow. Okay? And I will appreciate the child who will give the maximum answers. Clear, class? Now, let us proceed to the most important topic, tables in HTML. What is table? Tables in writer. Tables in writer. What is table? Bete, table is arrangement of rows and columns. Horizontal are the rows and vertical are the columns. Vertical are the columns. Okay, am I clear? Where row and column they strike, that is called cell. So how to create table in Writer? Click on table tab. There are so many methods. I'm starting the topic of table. So for 2-3 lectures, continue, this topic will go on. There are so many methods for one particular operation. So be very alert in the table lecture. Okay. How to create table? Click on table menu, insert option, further choose table sub option. Click on table menu, choose insert option. Inside the insert option, choose table sub option. Insert table dialog box will appear. Specify the number of rows and columns. By default, 2 columns and 2 rows are already set up. You can increase the number of columns. You can increase the number of rows as per your convenience. Click on OK button and you will see the table of required dimension will appear on the screen. Along with this, see this toolbar. Can you see this toolbar, bete? This is called table toolbar. It will automatically appear when you will insert table. So this was the first method to insert the table in Writer. Let me tell you second method. Control plus F12 shortcut key. The shortcut key to create table is Control plus F12. I have a question. What is the shortcut key for non-printing characters? Who will tell? Shortcut key for non-printing characters. Yes, Prabhjot. Unmute yourself, bache.
Sir, Control plus F10.
Excellent response. Excellent. Shabash. Control plus F12 is the shortcut key to create table. So I press Control plus F12. The same insert table dialog box appears. You can make the required settings as per your convenience. And table will appear on the screen. Okay. Am I clear? This was second method to insert table. Now third method. You can see this table icon on standard toolbar. Can you see this table icon on standard toolbar? Click here. And select the desired number of rows and columns you want. The table will get insert in your Writer work area. Clear? Am I clear totally? Now cursor will blink in the first cell and you can type your data. In order to move to the next cell, press the tab key. मंडे फर्स्ट पीरियड इंग्लिश, सेकेंड पीरियड कंप्यूटर, ट्यूजडे फर्स्ट पीरियड मैथ्स, सेकेंड पीरियड साइंस. एम आई क्लियर अप टिल हियर?